This is probably more related to drag applications where we're running on a methanol fuel, very short runs, where it's quite common to solid fill the block with a grout or solid filling compound to gain a little bit of strength. We've got no water there. You offer the option of running a complete dry deck surface but still retaining water in the block. Can you tell me how that works and why that's an advantage?
There are some races have asked for us to do it this way because that allows them to run cooling in the block but without the water running through the deck and into the head. And so they run two separate systems, one in the block and one in the head, and then they plug the holes in the cylinder head, and then we just machine the block so there's no coolant channels going through the deck. And they want to do that because they think that by running the water in the block, it may keep it a little bit cooler during the pass, and it may limit when the detonation point might hit. I mean, the guys these days are at 95 to 100 PSI, and, you know, so once you get up to those levels, it makes a big difference. Some of those things can make a big difference, you know.
Now, I just want to touch on the advantages, though, of not having that water transferring through the block into the cylinder head. There can be some problems with water going through that. If the head does still lift or we have a head gasket failure, that water can be do quite a dramatic amount of damage to the block. Can you tell me how that works, the mechanics of that situation?
Well, what it looks like someone's taken to the top of the block with a blowtorch. And the reason for that is that when you have the pressures so high, cylinder pressures are so high, you've got so much fuel pouring in. Once that gasket fails, the flame front, when it hits the water vaporizes, which has oxygen in it, and it just, you know, it basically turns it into an oxy torch.
So removing that water, the ability for that to happen, even if we have a head gasket failure, it means that you're not going to lose the cylinder head and the block.
Yeah, I mean, it limits the damage. I mean, the guys now are running copper alloy O-rings. When they're in those applications where they have so much boost that, and they go to a billet head as well, because the surface of the head was no longer stable enough, a factory head, to hold the head gasket as well. But, you know, they're the extreme cases. In the water block, or like the street or circuit block, at this stage we don't know where the failure point is, but we have tested to 300 horsepower per cylinder, and the head gasket is fine without an O-ring.
If you like that video, make sure you give it a thumbs up. And if you're not already a subscriber, make sure you're subscribed. We release a new video every week. And if you like free stuff, we've got a great deal for you. Click the link in the description to claim your free spot to our next live lesson.